we have just got off the subway and we are in Times Square. Not quite in it, but pretty much in it. We're going to go meet our friends because we're doing a tour of Rockefeller Center. But this is cool. Everyone's rushing around. They just need to take a chill pill. We are officially in Times Square. That's where they dropped the ball at New Year's Eve. And they like advertising here.
It is so busy. It's crazy. I got to keep eye on my wife. It's crazy busy. Look at this advertisement.
New York, baby. Well, we haven't been to Times Square for quite a few years, I think. There's the steps you can go up. We appeared on that billboard once. They were doing videos, taking pictures of people. Me and Sue got on there. This is amazing. We are going up the Rockefeller Center and we are hopefully booked in to be raised up on one of these steel things and get a photo all together, all being well. So that's what it was before.
Yeah.
And this is what it is now. Wow. What a difference.
Yeah.
That's 1 million. 1 million. Most expert time. 1 million. This is at the Rockefeller. Unbelievable. I'm probably going to pick up on the camera, but they're famous. Oh, I think I've seen her on the left on the TV. So, yeah, we got to keep walking now. At the top of this building is a $14 million apartment. That's Lego Rockefeller Center, and we are at Rockefeller Center. How crazy is that? That's what it looks like then, and that's what it looks like now. All built around. What a difference. Well, there's Rockefeller Center, and we'll be up there in a bit. Look at the size of this thing. That's where we're going. This is the second most photographed piece of statue in New York. The first one is Statue of Liberty. And that's the second one. Called Prometheus. Here's a closer look at it. And this area normally is an ice rink in winter. But yeah, cool. This is what it originally looked like.
Christmas Day 1936.
The garden.
It's a shame they didn't keep it, huh?
So in 1936 came an ice rink because this iced up one day and they thought, right, let's bring the farmers down and create an ice rink. That's what they did. This artwork records our reflection. Me and Sue.
Oh. That's cool, isn't it?
Look at this art. This is at the Rockefeller Center in New York City. All these buildings are owned by the family Rockefeller. They built them all. Amazing wealth. They had some money. 400 billion, I think, was in today's money. Quite a lot.
Of inspiring. inspiring views and exciting experiences await you.
Here's the first part. I'm on top of the rock. Can't see down the bottom. We're going to go higher in a minute now. This is quite a view. There's Central Park. This is the one. There's another, sorry, I'm trying to say it in English. There's another level. So this is pretty high, but we're going to get a little higher again. Where they don't have any glass. Look, put your hand through that. Oh, weird, isn't it? I think we're so high. And there's the Empire State Building right there. That's the Empire State Building. Just to the right of it is the One World Building as well. So that beam in a minute we're going to sit on. So then get a photo, like, recreate that historic photo with all the workers. Oh. It's just awesome. That garden on top of that skyscraper there. From up here you can see the New Year and New Year's Eve Times Square Boulevard. It's quite small, isn't it? That's the one that drops on New Year's Eve. That's quite small. So we'll try and zoom in on something down here. So tiny, the people down there. That's crazy. The Statue of Liberty there as well. I wonder if I can zoom into that. Well, let me just do the Statue of Liberty. That's the Statue of Liberty there. It's a bit smoggy from here. And then that's Empire State Building, and that one there is One World. That place is 9/11 building. I just can't get over zooming into people on the streets. It's mad. Awesome, isn't it? This is my little 360 of on top of the Rockefeller Centre. Try and get all the people out if I can. Just amazing. So we just did our bar photo. So they put you on this beam and then they raise you up, slide you over the glass and take some photos, which hopefully we'll show you in a minute. But we've just come back up for some last minute views of all, because it's just awesome. Just can't get over how high you are. So this is what we just did. They take you up and then I think they take a photo from behind, I'm not sure, and then they spin you around. Look how high you are there. And then they take a photo at the front. Go and see what they're like in a minute. Probably me like that. They already be an improvement, I'm sure. Okay, I'm on top of the Rockefeller Center and out the window is Empire State Building, amongst others. And I'm going to try the cappuccino. And it tastes good. I think it tastes good being so high up as well. Can't believe there's Empire State. It's crazy, isn't it?
We're now going to make our way to the Chrysler Building and then to Grand Central Station, but I just can't believe the Empire State Building is just there. Amazing, isn't it?
I invite you to explore the rest of Rockefeller Center and hope you'll come back to visit us again soon.
Of your visit. Oh, yeah, good. Well done. It. That's a Chrysler Building there, and we are going to go into the Grand Central Station, which is round here somewhere. Look how beautiful this place is. We're going to go in there in a minute, which is even prettier.
Yeah, it's warm just like you
said. Just such for a train station. It's such an amazing place. Here we go.
Most of us to our right. This is...
Oh, that's somewhere to eat, I think, in here. Right in this corner is the... Oh, look. Look at this. Yeah. Well, the count says it's quite a famous oyster bar restaurant, which we're going to go into now. And I guess have an oyster. Okay, we're inside it now. Look at this, beautiful. This is our table. Here I am, I've ordered clam chowder. I nearly ordered the wrong clam chowder. Oh. Oh, okay. What do you do? Sort of sprinkle them in? Yeah.
Right on.
Oh, give me some crackers. Give this a go then. Mm. Oh, that's delicious. That is delicious. So now I've put some of these oyster crackers in.
It's a little clam there then.
Mm.
Ah, look at that.
Lovely. My mate has given me one of his oysters. This is Oysters Rockefeller. I'm just going to shove it in.
What is it? Tell me about it.
Oh, look at that. Delicious.
Cheese, oyster, and spinach.
Is the lemon juice? Is the spring onion?
That was delicious. Well, I cleared that very quickly. And then my wife was saying she didn't really like her cheesecake. And he said, so I said to her, and he said, I don't like key lime pie. That is why. It's key lime. She now has cheesecake. My wife ordered cheesecake, but they accidentally served her key lime pie. So I'm going to have a go. Do you know what it tastes like?
The giveaway was a bit of lime on top.
It's a big go, isn't it?
I thought, oh, well, they're just separating
it. Not bad. Well,
right.
I prefer cheesecake. So my wife can eat all the cheesecake, American, well, New York cheesecake in New York. Mm, you know that's good. You just know that's spot on. Well, there's the Flatiron Building, and as I called it when I first came to New York, Flatiron. What a donut. It's full of scaffolding though, but you probably make out the outline of it. And this is where we are. We're in the concrete jungle.
We are now on the High Line, and this is a disused railway line that they got rid of because the locals were saying it's too noisy, which you can understand because it goes right past people's houses. But they saved it because they wouldn't demolish it and build on it. So they saved it, so it's literally walking through New York. It's on a high level. It's just beautiful. You've got, as you can see, lots of artwork on the way through as well. Lots of trees and shrubs and all sorts. This is so peaceful to just walk through. You wouldn't think we're in the middle of New York. But there's the old railway line there. All grown over now with shrubs and trees. This is what New York should be like. Just all trees. And a few little paths, but mainly trees. Helicopter just taking off in front of us. Still on the High Line. This bit feels new to me. I could be wrong, man. I often am. All this, and this is stunning. I can see three helicopters in the sky at the moment. No, four. All doing trips. We are still walking the skyline. It's still just beautiful.
High Line,
sorry, not skyline. And what I'm amazed at is it was supposed to rain this afternoon and we've not had a drop. We've been so fortunate. We thought it was going to be tipping down all afternoon. So far, so good. Long may it last. This little mouse. Just walking along. I wonder if I can get ahead of him and see if he'll... There he is. I wonder if he'll just... Nope. He's gone. Didn't seem to be that bothered though. We're in the subway now and it's hot again. Waiting for our train to go to our restaurant. All being well, it doesn't take too long. Normally no longer than 5 minutes. We have arrived at Gallagher's Steakhouse. It's famous for steaks. Starting to see why it's famous for steaks. A lot of meat in there. That's a lot of, oh my life. That's ridiculous amounts of meat. Must be about a dozen cows in there or more. Anyway, here we go.
Right.
Coming here and you think it's not gonna be busy. No, it's not, it's packed. Fortunately, we have a reservation. So we decided we didn't like the steak place because it was full of some, I don't know, toffee nose people, that's four. And so we're going to Ellen's Stardust, which we've been to many times before, so we're just waiting to see if we can get in. So I got Andy to work his little bit of magic, and we got to Ellen's Stardust earlier. So in a minute, we're gonna be able to, thank you Andy, in a minute we're gonna be able to hear a singer or two sing down there and have some fun. Trying to become famous. So what they're serving, they also sing. And they're all very talented, as you can hear. Sound like me.
Close his eyes and go! Close your eyes. Thank you. Let me go. They won't never. Close your eyes!
Tomorrow won't remind me of today. Alright, keep it like that.
Thank you.
When the city's smiling sweet.
That's our waiter.
I get on a train that's bound for Santa Fe.
That's great. So we've got some Philly cheesesteak to share. Look at that. Oh. And what are these?
Mozzarella
bites. Let's try this though. Oh. Look at that. And our waitress is singing. Amazing. Well, that was a lot of fun. We're now walking to our subway and we're in Times Square, as you can see by all the advertisements. So our subway's only 10 minutes away. Subway, bus, home, shower, bed. Now we're really in Times Square. I mean, it's like it's daytime, but it's 8, 9 o'clock at night. They're still working on buildings. You can still hear machinery going on. Crazy. We're on the bus, nearly home, and to bed.